Today we'll be showing you how to do referencing of unpinned MPO cabling using the gender neutral cord method. This process will require a total of 3 cords to conduct and verify the results of your reference. We'll make use of 2 test cords called TRC1 and TRC2. TRC1 at least must have the ability for us to add and remove its alignment pins, which is typically done with a tool such as this one. TRC2 will remain pinned at one end and unpinned at the other. Once a reference has been completed, we'll want to verify that both TRCs are in good condition by connecting them via a cord which simulates the cable under test. In this case, this third cord will be unpinned at both ends. And we'll be making use of reverse key adapters to connect the components during this test process. The first step in referencing is to ensure that all of your test cords and the ports in your testers are clean. For this, we'll emphasize the inspect before you connect approach using appropriate viewing scopes and cleaning materials. So to begin, first of all, make sure you charge your testers ahead of time, but make sure your source unit is powered on but disconnected from the power for at least 20 minutes before you begin. To begin with, we're going to conduct a reference with TRC1. And to do this, we're going to connect the 2 units together, first of all by locating the pinned and unpinned ends of the cord. In this case, this is already an unpinned end, which we are going to plug into the power source. The second end is currently retaining pins. So in order to connect the 2 units together, we're going to have to remove these pins temporarily. In order to do that, we take the special tool for this, plug in the cord, insert a retaining clip, utilize the gripping tool to hold the clip, squeeze the tool, squeeze the gripper, and the pins have been extracted. Now what we can do is insert the other end of TRC1 into our meter. Once connected, the 2 units will make a tone to confirm that they are connected. So now we can go ahead and begin our referencing. So hit the action key, set reference, and next. Here the results have come back good, it's showing green. I can click into the details to have a look at the values per core. But now this means I'm good to go ahead, and if I'm happy, I can click next to store the reference result. Now I'm going to go on to the verification step. In order to verify our reference, what we're going to do is we are going to now combine all 3 of these cords together. TRC1, which you've already been using, plus TRC2 and the cable under test. Now, as you recall, this cable in particular is unpinned at both ends. So what we're going to need to do here is add back in the pins into the end of TRC1, which is a very straightforward procedure. Essentially, all we do is we take our connector, pop it back into our pin exchange tool. We take the clip, which has the pins in it from when we removed them before, slide this into place with a click, and then we can just remove the connector from the tool, and that's ready for us to use. So I'm going to pop that into the scope temporarily on the source, just for safekeeping. Now I'm going to look for the unpinned end of TRC2, which is this end here. So that I'm going to plug into the power meter. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to mate it with one end of the unpinned cord, like so. And then I'm going to take my TRC1, which I added the pins back into just now. I'm going to use another adapter, and I'm going to connect it into the cable under test. Okay, so now we'll hear an audible tone to say the units are communicating once more. And we're going to hit next to do our test. that has given us a pass. So we can now go into the results, have a look at confirming the polarity is what we expected, confirm the length is what we expected, make a look through each of the two wavelengths, in this case 1310 and 1550, see the results across all 12 fibers. So that has now successfully verified our reference. We can go ahead and save that. And we are ready to begin testing. So that concludes the setup and referencing of the Tier 1 MPOLx loss testing kit. So now both units are ready to go and you can begin testing in your project.